One of the two Californians who triggered the Proposition 13 tax-cutting revolt now has a new target, government spending. His Proposition 4 would put a lid on it. Bernard Goldberg reports.
California was the epicenter of the tax quake of 78, and they were the Shakers, Howard Jarvis and Paul Gann, two senior citizen tax revolutionaries who co-authored Proposition 13. It was Jarvis who made the newscast and the cover of the news magazines, but now the lesser-known half of the tax-cutting team, 67-year-old Paul Gann, has gone off on his own, has come up with his own anti-spending, anti-big-government proposition, complete with an anti-bureaucracy media blitz.
This November, take a bureaucrat to lunch. Tell him you're tired of wasteful government spending. Tell him you'll no longer tolerate fat treasury surpluses and excessive taxes. Tell him it's time the people took control of gluttonous government spending. And if he still doesn't get the message, tell him you're voting yes on Proposition 4.
Proposition 4 clamps a lid on how much tax money state and local officials could spend, limiting spending to current levels, plus adjustments for inflation and population growth. And while Gann campaigns for Proposition 4, he reminds voters it would even force officials to rebate all tax money they haven't spent.
We've just about had a belly full of the growth of government, the cost of government, the waste, the absolute almost criminal carelessness in the manner in which they spend tax money.
A recent poll of California voters showed that 61% favor Proposition 4, 28% oppose it, and 11% can't decide. But unlike the Proposition 13 campaign, this time there's no major debate. In fact, there is virtually no vocal, organized opposition to 4. That is partly because the gloom and doom predictions that 13 would lead to wholesale layoffs and cutbacks in services never materialized, and partly because of a post-Proposition 13 atmosphere. Gann and his backers sponsored a marathon in Los Angeles recently, cozying up to what may be the biggest voting bloc in the state, joggers, and focusing attention on the pro-4 motto, trim the fat. But opponents, what few there are, say too often lawmakers think trim the fat means cut services to the poor.
They will look around and whoever they can cut services on, it's not going to cost them their next election. That's the services they'll cut.
Well, what does that mean?
Usually that means poor people.
If Paul Gann and the polls are right, Proposition 4, like Proposition 13 before it, should win easily. And if that happens, Gann says he'll be taking his tax crusade to the rest of the nation, pushing for what the tax rebels see as utopia, a constitutional amendment to limit federal spending. Bernard Goldberg, CBS News, San Francisco.